there's a real sense of disjunction at the moment, that a feeling that the world is exciting and moving forward, but also I can't cope. It's just always on too fast. You know, I talked to someone in his 80s who was a very senior director at Shell before he retired. And he said to me, he had no idea. He had literally no idea how people could work today. He said, you know, so he was one of the top eight in Shell. And he said, my life was slow, measured, simple. We took our time. We wrote letters. He said, you know, we never, ever. And how people can cope with all of this stuff flying in and instant decisions. And so he said, I'm in awe of people working today because I couldn't do it. It's very interesting. And it was all about speed. All about speed. So I think we adapt, you know, that we are definitely adapting. You know, I would say the amount of information I process in a day, my father would have processed in a year, probably, or in a month, or, you know, there's no way that, you know, he in comparison, there's no comparison to the way that I work, and therefore probably my productivity, and the things that I can output that he, you know, he would have taken him a week, I can do in an hour. It's also scary that the fact that the pressure is never ending. So I think that's a key issue. And I have no answers to how do we manage that. We don't stop. We can't stop. We have to just apply filters. And I think the way that people are dealing with it is that the old traditional method, you know, the getting things done, the Allen model, which is you focus on one thing at a time. And in that moment, you are shutting everything else out, and then you focus on another thing, and you don't let the flow overwhelm and panic you. Because I meet people in panic, literally in panic. They spend their lives in panic, and it's scary, and it's not good. You burn out. That's how burnout happens, when you're going too fast for your own comfort.